Ahoy there, and welcome back to the Pirate's Poetry Corner and General Thinkin' Spot here. Today we'll be reading a poem by Benjamin Franklin. Now a lot of you may say, oh, Benjamin Franklin, he was a philosopher, or he was a statesman, or he was a scientist, you know, who discovered the principles of electricity by sticking his finger in the light socket, or touching the key, or whatever it is that he did, you know, when he got... It seems like a little crazy to me, but, you know, I'm just, you know, a simple old pirate. But a lot of us may not realize that Benjamin Franklin was also a brewer and a publisher and a pretty accomplished writer. So, and you know, Benjamin Franklin, he gave us the saying, beer is proof that God loves us and wants us to be happy. I can agree with that a little bit, you know. Beer is proof that God loves us and wants us to be happy. And maybe, you know, beer with a little rum, you know, rum with a beer chaser. There you be, as a pirate, that would be the way to go. But this, of course, has nothing to do with today's poem, entitled The Antediluvians Were All Very Sober. Well, now, come to think of it, it might have a wee bit to do with today's poem. But at any rate, the Antediluvians, we're speaking of, you know, the people before the flood. And by the flood, we mean the Great Flood. So, you know, Noah and Shem and Ham and Japheth and all those folk, we're talking about people before them, were all very, very sober. Right, so here we go. The Antediluvians Were All Very Sober by Benjamin Franklin. The Antediluvians were all very sober, for they had no wine, and they brewed no October. Brew in October, that's a reference to October ale. You know, you brew that after the mash has had a chance to ferment a wee bit, you know, that you've harvested in the fall, and it's... Anyway, we don't need a lecture on how to brew your beer. I'm sure you brew your own just fine. But here we go back to the poem. All wicked, bad livers on mischief still thinking, for there can't be good living where there is not good drinking. Well, you know, I suppose you could make the statement for that, you know. You know, the pirates, we love our rum. It's our favourite beverage. But a good ale is nice, too. Sorry, I digress. Anyway, so there cannot be good living where there is not good drinking. Derry down, derry down. Now, derry down, that's a phrase that they were using in the 18th century, sort of as a nonsensical phrase. You know, 100 years earlier, in Shakespeare's time, they might have been saying, fa-la-la-la-la, or hey, nonny, nonny, you know, hey, nonny, nonny, hey, nonny, nonny, sort of something like that, you know. But in Franklin's time, they were saying derry down. But it all works out to the same thing. Whoop-de-doo. You know, today we say, hey, baby, baby, you know, but at any rate, we'll get back to the poem now. Stanza 2. 'Twas honest old Noah first planted the vine, and mended his morals by drinking its wine. He justly the drinking of water decried, for he knew that all mankind, by drinking it, died. Derry down, derry down. Hey, nonny, nonny. Well, you know, I suppose you could make the case that all mankind dies by drinking water, or everyone who drinks water dies. Well, I suppose you could say that, you know, it's like everyone who's alive dies, or everyone who's died everyone who has ever died has been alive. It's sort of like a self-fulfilling kind of a thing, you know. All mankind by drinking it died. He's just being a wee bit silly here, you know. So, stanza 3. From this piece of history, plainly we find that water is good neither for body nor mind. That virtue and safety in wine bibings found. While all the drink water deserved to be drowned. Daddy down, daddy down. Right, so for safety and honesty, put the glass round. And as a pirate, I say I can get behind that sentiment, you know. Put the glass round. Let's all have a round of the rum. Or maybe a round of the beer or the stout. Or even the wine, you know. If you like the wine, go ahead and have a little bit of wine. That'd be just fine by me. Right, so that'd be all for today's Pirate's Poetry Corner and General Thinkin' Spot. So we'll say fair winds to your sails. Keep your powder dry and your weather eye open. And we'll see you next time.